To start this recording.
ओके
हेलो
यस सर
ओके सो सो टुडे फर्स्ट एरर लॉग टू शो यू फिक्स दिस एंड व्हाट पॉसिबल ऑप्शंस
आई हैव क्वेश्चन हाउ टू क्रिएट अ एरर लॉग फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल
Okay, you don't need to create. Just once you get the error, then you know how to fix that.
ओके
Created this to show you the error type and the solution to fix that. Okay, so once you run this, you will get nothing here. No farm name, no server. In our 6.5 environment, we have this much servers available and support PC. Here is a VDA of 7.x and DVD 0. So, apart from this, this is the database server, which I have created separately for 6.5. Okay. I just logged in into that. So, first of all, we'll show you about the license. For license server, the option program file Citrix. Also, from the Citrix, here I can get all the tools of Citrix. Xenap 6.5 is an administration tool. It's a pre installed. When you install 6.5, these tools are pre installed. Management console. App Center, single sign on, Xenap migration. Xenap migration is not in use because we are not migrating 6.5 to 7.2. Creating that, moving the server from 6.5 servers to 7.x, we uninstall 6.5 and install the VDA on that.
These files are comes by default on 6.5.
Yeah, it's a pre-installed. It's installed by default. When we install 6.5, then at 6.5, these options comes by default in the server. So once it's installed, we can go to the programs. From here, we can open the license management console. Okay. So license management console looks like this. This is my license manager. Okay. We'll get the detail of the license or license server. The license server name can be mentioned in the top or once it login. It's asking for the what is your and that you can use. same user, Citrix/administrator. Okay, I logged in into the server. After login, I will call these options: system in configuration, server configuration. Port 27000. Host name, you can see the host name is in cat. Okay. Same thing, we can find the C type. You go to 186 Citrix, and here you need to find the is an app to blah blah this. Okay, go to the licensing, you will get the with dot lic. Okay, are you getting this dot lic? Let me show if it's here. Yeah, I will. And you will get the server name. It's showing the server name is in caps. So always check that your host name is in caps or is wrong. Properties, and see here. Same name here. Once I make any changes in the server host name, if I will suppose like I have put it all in small, okay, and in this file is in the host name is binded with the license and it's a case sensitive.
So I'll so first always it should be case sensitive later.
The same as it's mentioned in the license. Sorry.
Okay.
Or first you create the license server and same name should be in the license. With both are same. If it's the server is a caps, all caps, then in the license file, or it should be in all caps. If it's all small, it should be in the license file. It's all small. Server is the mix. Is first letters caps and other small. License file, it should be on same format.
What may be the server like in?
Understand case sensitive means.
Okay.
Means the format is mentioned over there, the same format should be in the license.
If both are not same, so which type of problem will come?
It's not matching or it's not showing its name. If we, when we searching the that default servers, it will not be reflected in the what we call this sheet.
Mm-hmm.
It should be mismatched, no? Sir, you are muted. Your voice is muted.
Oh, this is the IP address, and this is IP version 6. This is the complete FQDN host name. So in the system information, we'll get these. Okay. In the user configuration, we can add user over here. Suppose I want to give Durges rights as the license administrator. Okay. Here we have option to add a local managed user as well as a domain.
Okay.
I can add local users as the domain. Just we need to confirm the password. We need to add this. And user will add the list. Okay.
Sir, so I have. We have created on a license server.
Yeah. Pardon?
How many users we have created in license server?
For security purpose, we never add any user except the administrator.
Actually, some limits set here.
Limits we can add 100 of the servers here, but we never add 100 of the server. We add only one domain and one local.
Okay.
And that user ID and password is shared.
Because
all members of the team are getting access on the license. If license server crashed, then everything goes.
Sir, also it's a showing domain admin group. It's a.
I have shown you now. We can add domain administrator, domain group, local, anything we can add. If you want to add a local user over here, we can add the local.
Okay, local users.
If you want to use domain group, we can add them.
Okay.
That's why I have added a local administrator domain. This is built-in administrator, domain admin. You can type. And this is domain admin. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Next is alert configuration. Which kind of alert you will get in the license server? Also. So this is the option which I am showing after log. Okay, it's a vendor daemon. What is vendor daemon? Can anyone tell me? Vendor daemon. Check in, check out, something like that. Get the detail of checkout licenses. Okay. Vendor daemon port 7279.
7279.
Okay. So these are the whatever we want, we can check. But mostly we use the default type software. This is server configuration. You can see the web server. The web server, this one 8082. You can see the port number 8082. 8082 is the license management port.
Yes.
Okay. Maximum number of web servers 10. It's a default thing. Okay. Secure web configuration is a 8082, which you can see here. This is the default certificate, default server key to access license management. License server configuration. Here also nothing is about the port only. Use default port 2700 or 27009. Means from this to this you can use. If you don't want to use 2700.
Okay, actually it would be like a 27,000 series or
27,009.
Suppose, but don't suppose in the IPP, but suppose this port is already used by some other application.
Okay.
Some application is configured for this port already. And after that, you want to create the ZNAP in that. And that port is not sick. It's already in use. In case you can go with this. But for the best practices, Citrix always says that always use the default. Okay.
Sir, your maximum number means kya hai
actually it's a mac it's a would be in 27,000 and 20 between 27,009
no he is not asking this he is asking this.
Yes this
so,
one
this is the default value of threads which he can send server can send or server can receive but don't focus on this I'm just giving you the main options which are very much required and today by 8 I will connect you guys again okay so this is the port and the login the information error information warning so whatever you want you can select and view the file what are the logs generated let it be there okay then user interface about the license activatable license concurrent license both okay so I'm using concurrent that's why it's concurrent both I can select the both okay yeah then it's a vendor demand configuration import just click here and you will get the option to import the license file
okay
so wherever your LIC file is just you can select the file and you can open. But it should be .lic okay
okay
now second option if you have a license file directly you can go and you can paste it in the this
one C drive license folder
licensing my file folder you can put your license file
so when we have put the file licensing file in my my files then it's automatically
picked by console
okay
this is your vendor daemon port just click here once you click on the vendor daemon port use 7279 read license file stop report log name you can generate but this is your license directory vendor daemon use default port use this port 7279 always it's go with the 7279 okay
yes
definition of a vendor daemon
is granting the licensing
licensing name license
license
is take the count of checkout license
yes
okay yes. I'm just giving you single line as now going to the dashboard so sir, in the dashboard there are two things this is alert and here the licenses we have uploaded like here platinum concurrent we have available 670 licenses used 0 these are the default license startup license the value of that is now 10,000 okay one license is in server is on startup license is for Citrix Zenap servers and Zenap concurrent license is for the users okay license is startup license is for the Citrix servers how many servers in the environment each server will get one startup license okay and concurrent license is for the Citrix users who will access the application from Citrix URL clear is all about Citrix license server nothing extra needed apart from this
what happen if license server goes down
ek minute ke liye main recording band karu bhai sunna kya chahte ho tum log मैंने किस मूड में हो पैसा वेस्ट करना है तुम्हें तो बताओ, तीन बार बता चुका हूँ व्हाट हैपेंस इफ लाइसेंस सर्वर गोज डाउन। दुर्गेश आंसर देना।
सर इट्स गिवन दैट 30 डेज इट्स अ ग्रेस पीरियड फॉर
ओके।
किसने पूछा था ये क्वेश्चन?
सर आई आस्क
भाई यार क्यों अपना पैसा वेस्ट कर रहे हो यार फिर मेरे चक्कर?
नो सर जस्ट एक क्वेरी
नहीं क्वेरी नहीं क्वेरी क्वेरी कल भी रात को मैंने सॉल्व की थी एक मिनट को यार। तो नाउ विल गो टू द लाइसेंस फाइल इज अ लाइसेंसिंग वी हैव दिस फोल्डर अवेलेबल इन द लाइसेंस। तो माई फाइल इज टू स्टोर द लाइसेंस फाइल। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू द ls इज अ कॉन्फिगरेशन हियर नथिंग नीड टू चेंज एक्सेप्ट इफ वी वॉन्ट वी कैन ओपन और आई कैन ओपन दिस httpd। दिस फाइल इज रिलेटेड टू द एक्सेस द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर विच इज लॉगिंग इन टू द सर्वर दैट वी कैन मैनेज बट नीड टू चेंज सम चेंजेस make some changes on this file but it's not for the production environment. Okay, apart from this these are the commands exe. Okay, लाइसेंस सर्वर इज कॉमन फॉर
6.5 7.8 7.15।
तो दीस कमांड्स आर यू कैन यूटिलाइज इन द 7.x एंड यू विल गेट द सेम। सो आई विल शो दीस कमांड्स इन द 6.5 7.x एनवायरनमेंट आल्सो। ओके, अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस इज अ लाइसेंस कॉन्फिग फाइल इज अ कॉन्फिगरेशन यू थिंग्स एंड nothing extra need to learn in the license. Only you need to check that vendor daemon is service is running or not. Like here, you need to check the alerts of the license server for both versions, as well as you need to check the utilize licenses. If you want to create the list of the servers which are the member of Citrix XenApp environment or ZenDesktop, just go to the startup license and in the host, you can click and download the list. Suppose there are 100 servers in your environment, 2 DDC, DDC means 7.x, delivery controller, 50-60 VDAs, and as well as 2 ZDC and 20 ZenApp servers. Okay, so all servers list you can get from here. From startup you will get the mix list of the servers is included with the 6.5 and 7.5. It is some and this kind of screen. If you want to export data, you can export it in CBS format.
Okay.
Okay. So I'm just closing this session.